Philippine Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri rebuffed by journalists after he suggests that the news media help beautify the country's image. Zubiri made the appeal after the UN Human Rights Committee expressed concern over the red tagging of journalists, government critics, and human rights defenders. The National Union of Journalists of the Philippines, or NUJP, reminds Zubiri that the media's first loyalty is to the public and its first obligation is to tell the truth. NUJP Chairperson Jonathan De Santos also says the government cannot deny how a chilling effect now exists among the ranks of the country's journalists.
There's a saying, or there's a slogan, that there is no democracy without press freedom. And even though we can argue that we have some freedoms, the fact that there are threats or that there are limits to that also speaks to the democracy that we have. Zubiri also pointed out that the press is more controlled, for example, in Malaysia or in Vietnam. No? But that doesn't really help the Philippine situation. That doesn't really comfort us at all. It just shows that press freedom is threatened everywhere, and it's something that we have to work together to protect and defend.
Former UP Mass Communications Dean Luis Teodoro warns the public may lose its trust in the media if it heeds Zubiri's call.
Isang paraan niya para mawala ng tiwala ang mga kamayan sa media kasi pinalalabas mo na ang media nagkakalat lang ng mga sasamang bagay sa bayan so on, at hindi tumutulong. Ang media mayroong malaking papel din talaga sa paglalat ng isang bayan sa pamamagitan ng pagsasabi ng totoo. Para yung mga mali mabago, maiba, no? Maremedyohan, and so on. At saka yung mga tama ipagpatuloy.
The self-confessed gunman in the Percy Lapid murder case claims one of his co-conspirators identified suspended prison's chief, Gerald Bantag, as the mastermind. This new revelation was made by Joel Escorial as the supposed source of his information was laid to rest in his hometown. Rafi Santos reports.
The alleged middleman in the Percy Lapid murder, June Villamor, was buried in Leyte Province Wednesday. Aside from family and friends, including Villamor's sister, who is under the government's witness protection program, DOJ and PNP personnel were also on hand to secure the burial. Villamor's death came shortly after he was identified by self-confessed gunman Joel Escorial as the one who brokered the hit. Escorial earlier faced an ABS-CBN news team and shared more details on the Lapid slaying. He says Villamor was a childhood friend and that days after the killing of Lapid, Villamor called him from prison, informing him of a potential safe house where he could lie low. According to Escorial, it was Villamor who told him that suspended Bucor chief Gerald Bantag is the mastermind behind Lapid's killing. Villamor also made Escorial promise not to reveal the alleged mastermind behind the broadcaster's slay while he is still alive. Escorial adds, his last phone call with Villamor happened on October 16 when he bared his growing uneasiness inside Bilibid.
Namamalam. Sabi niya sa akin na pagtawag niya na mayroon akong sasabihin sa iyo, ingatan mo. Kasi malaking daw ito. Yan nga po sabi niya si Bantag daw nag-utos na patayin si Percy.
Escorial admits he started fearing for his life when he learned Bantag was allegedly behind the killing, prompting him to surrender and confess to the crime. Escorial also says Villamor first called him on September 6 about the plot to kill Lapid, promising a hefty fee for the murder. The gunman says he had second thoughts but he was eventually persuaded by his friend.
Para daw mapabilis yung nila, yung paglaya nila, sikasuhin daw po yung papel. Kaya tinanggap ko yung tabaho na yun.
Paano daw? Paano?
Sa pamamaraan ng parang mababawasan yung nila, sentensya.
He admits Villamor's death hit him hard.
Minsan nga napaiyak ako. Pag naalala ko yung mga ba namin, yung mga biro niya, mga dami kasi kaming pinagsamahan nun.
Escorial says he is ready to face the consequences of his actions. He also believes the mastermind should also face the music. Rafi Santos, ABS-CBN News.